To all my sons worldwide, all my juniors, I apologize for my absence. I know I left you without a name or job.
We turn it up.
Daddy's home.
Yo, first of all, nigga, you don't start the fucking record off talking about like, all right, guys, daddy's home.
Yeah. Like, y'all know what it is.
Talking to all the rap niggas out here, just like, okay, y'all had y'all fun. Okay, daddy's
all
home.
My son, sit down.
What kind of shit this nigga be talking about, dog? This nigga got some kind of fucking nerve, bro.
He knows.
Oh yeah, we having fun. We're gonna have fun this episode. They done fucked up and gave me the buttons. I did that on purpose. Drake, you're not slick. Drake, you're not slick. Find your name on the dot. Kendrick, K dot. I know what you're saying, man. That's a little subliminal shit that they be doing. Like the little like side jumps, you know what I mean?
It's arguable. I'm not saying I would. I'm just saying like that's those subliminals that really be having the fans like.
Drake is super, super petty. We're going to get into this album. Like, there's some records in here. This nigga is really, really petty. Like, some shit I thought that he forgot about, he didn't.
No.
He saved it for this album for sure.
Come on, Karen. I love
Now I'm ready.
Okay, we ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. It's the pretty boys versus the petty boys.
Sold out already, got a whole new set of toys. There's so much about this album. I'm gonna keep playing records because there's so many records to play.
So many.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey. Now I'm gonna be honest, guys. I'm gonna be real honest with Pod.
I already know what you're gonna say. Same thing I'm thinking.
Probably. We didn't talk at all. Like, so if you guys don't know, we try to be as organic and authentic as possible. Like me and Jamila, we're real good friends. We talk all the time. But before the pod, I try not to bring up like the music conversation.
I'm glad you did. I started to call you and I was like, I'm just gonna save it for the podcast.
I was thinking the same thing. Like after I heard, I was just like, I was about to drop it in the group chat, but I was like, you know what? No, let me.
Because they were doing some talking.
They were doing some talking in the group chat,
and I wanted to put my two cents in, and I decided not to say anything.
I was about to leave a deposit.
Was you?
I was, but okay. Let's talk about this album, Drake, Certified Lover Boy. First.
I'm so glad that you dropped it. Yes. And I want to also start by saying, I love Drake. I love Drake.
I'm a fan of Drake.
Because for some odd reason, everything I'm going to say hereafter may be misconstrued that I don't. And if you watch previous episodes, I'm actually a Drake fanatic. And I also want to just say he's my favorite artist.
Just go back and listen to the Smiley reaction video and you will know.
I love Drake.
Right.
But right. I was very disappointed.
Yeah.
I was hoping to get some of that same verse and energy that he had on that Smiley joint.
Yeah.
There's not a song on this album that made me feel like that.
Yeah. All right. I'm gonna walk you through my Thursday of how I prepare for this album.
Okay.
All right. September 2nd, you know, it's Thursday, you know, after work. I don't work on Friday, so you know, I had shit to do.
All right,
I mean?
Now
I'm preparing myself, you know what I mean, for this album and what's going on. You know, I also went to go see the movie Shang-Chi.
Okay.
From Marvel. So I'm just like, yo, I just had this whole day planned. Like, it's just like, this is a good fucking day, right?
What a way to start your weekend.
I know, right? So I'm just like, this is good. Go to the movie. Movie was phenomenal. Was great. It's Marvel.
But you already knew that.
Come on now. You know, I thought, you know what, let me treat myself to something nice to eat. So I ordered me some good food, bring it back home.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I was just like, I'm not even going to cook tonight. I'm not even going to, why worry? Why worry
for
about
what?
That? Why? Come on now. I get home, I'm waiting for the album to drop. It's like, okay, midnight.
You stayed up for it?
Of course I did.
I intentionally didn't. See, I did it on purpose.
See, you're smart. You're smart. That's what you were supposed to do.
I slept on it. I was like, you know what? I can stay up. Mm-hmm. Or I can just start my day off right. Like, I know it's going to be there. Like, I know that he's not going to pull a Kanye on me. Like, right. It's going to be just waiting in the chamber for me when I wake up.
The reason why I waited, because I remember when certain Drake albums dropped at midnight. And I remember exactly where I was at, what I was doing, mm-hmm. stuff like that. Like, it's like one of my favorite Drake albums was If You're Reading This, It's Too Late. And when mm-hmm. I heard that, I remember reading Rap Genius as I'm listening to it at midnight. I was pressed. I love that album. So I'm expecting to get some kind of vibe like this. This is a very highly anticipated Drake album. This is the album that was supposed to drop January this year. So I'm just like, this joint has been sitting, cooking for an additional mm-hmm. 9 months. I'm like, oh, I know he's about to give it to him. And he got beef with Kanye?
What?
I'm like, yo, this shit about to go crazy.
Nothing but the hits.
Nothing but the hits. Nothing but the motherfucking hits. So midnight comes. I look, no music. I'm like,
I got nervous.
I'm like, this nigga did not just pull a Kanye.
He would never.
Right after Kanye.
He would never.
But of course, you know, I go to Twitter and, you know, he explains that his album will be dropping at 2 a.m. Why? Don't know. And I was just like, you know what? I'm going to wait for this.
That's okay.
I'm going to wait for this.
It's like going to a job interview and just not showing up and then just showing up late. Like, no, I called. You know what I mean? There happened to be an accident. I did leave an hour early, but this is one of those really bad accidents.
Right. And I don't know why. I don't know why I was pushed back an additional 2 hours. But it's cool. It's cool. It's like, okay, I'm going to wait. I wait an additional 2 hours. You know what I do? You guessed it. Play Donda.
As you waited.
Play Donda again. As I waited. I'm just like, okay, this joint better smoke this fucking album. Because everybody's anticipating is going to smoke this album. 2 o'clock comes.
Dun, 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 dun.
The pregnant emojis are here.
Still sickening to look at.
I press play, and this is what I hear.
I love you, I love you, I love you.
Stop. And I was like, okay, I'm tuned in.
I listen.
The album plays, and I get no feeling. I have no
waiting for
feeling.
It was like you were waiting for the build up.
I was waiting.
Like, okay. We warming up.
Right.
It's still lukewarm.
Right.
It's still lukewarm.
Right. And the intro was long, like a normal Drake intro to an album, which I'm not surprised. Like, Drake normally smokes intros to his album. Mm-hmm. But I didn't get that same feeling from this one. Mm-hmm. All right. Next record starts, Poppy's Home. And I hear,
I know that I hurt you.
Oh.
And I was like, okay. Yeah, track one.
Like, lukewarm. I was like, damn, this should have been an intro. You know what I mean? And I was like, I didn't really love it though. I didn't love it.
Right. It was good for a build up. Like, okay, I'm not gonna give you too much heat.
Right. And then after that, I completely got lost. It was just completely like flatline. You know what I mean? I there was no climax to any of the records at all. And then I hear this. For the first time, I hear this. I was like, no. What the fuck is this? What am I listening to? And I'm heated. I'm mad at this point. Because
you can tell that that's where the build-up was supposed to start, right?
Right,
but it didn't really do that for you.
It didn't do it. So, at this point, Jamila, I start falling asleep. I fell asleep. Like, I fell asleep right, like, probably, like, track 13 with 21 Savage and Project Pat. And I woke back up, and it was literally the end of the album. And I was just like, I cannot believe that, for one, I fell asleep to the Drake album. And for two, I'm not impressed. So then I was like, you know what? Let me.
Why were there so many songs?
Drake does this.
I know that.
Yeah.
But so many songs that just were not.
Right.
Like, at this point, it was like, I needed a deluxe. A fire.
Yeah.
Because you just gave us three tracks.
Right.
That was all fire.
Right. Yeah. I was like, maybe he might come up with a studio B, like a side B like he did with Scorpion or something like that. But no, I think this is it. So then I sat back and my first conclusion, first listen to the album, you know, with the exception of the three or four songs that I slept on, literally, I was like, this is mid. And I can't believe I'm saying this about Drake, that this is a mid album for Drake standards. Like, let's not get this twisted or misconstrued.
It was still good music, but it was just good. It was not great.
Right. And so I was like, you know what?
I was looking for unmatched.
Yeah.
Untouchable.
Right.
Album of the year.
Yeah.
Can't fuck with Cole's album.
Right. Right. You about to say it? She's about to say a hot take. We're not even there yet. So I was like, you know what? Let me go to sleep. Let me wake up. Let me get some fresh ears.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And I listen to the album again. Okay. The second listen gets a little bit better.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little bit better. I'm like, okay.
It's still getting better for me. Yeah. But it should. I'm not used to it taking this long.
Right. Right. And that's the thing. Like, Kanye and Drake are masterminds when it comes to making music that lasts the test of time. Like, they don't make music for right now.
Mm-hmm.
They make music that they plan to live on forever. Like, I can go back to Nothing Was the Same by Drake, mm-hmm, and be like, wow, I cannot believe I missed it, because I remember Take Care used to be my favorite older Drake project. That was Nothing Was the Same. But yeah, so I'm like, okay, so it's getting a little bit better, but that's still, that's that fucking Way Too Sexy record. I was just like, I cannot believe that this record is on here. And then guess what happened after the second listen? You guessed it. The fucking music video dropped. Way Too Sexy. Way Too Sexy. And I watched the video and I am crying laughing to this fucking video. Yeah, it's just like, it's genius marketing. Like, first it was just like, you're gonna pick the worst record on the whole album to be your lead single.
You thought that was the worst album, the worst song on the album?
At the time it was. Now it's not.
I still like the song.
Yeah.
I didn't love the song. Mm-hmm. I liked the song when I first heard it.
Mm-hmm.
But I was like, okay. Like, I seen, before the video came out, I saw the video. I saw the video. I was like,
this is so good. You saw Kawhi Leonard, dude?
I'm like, great.
Oh my God. Yo, so, and I'm ashamed to say that song did grow on me. Like, I started to fuck with it now.
The beat go. I'm not gonna fake.
Oh yeah, the beat goes hard.
The beat go. It's definitely a nice riding song.
For sure. And
Going back to the Certified Lover Boy, he got a great, yeah, because that's what we're supposed to be talking about, but it's just, it was mid. It wasn't bad. I'm still going to listen to it because that's, mm-hmm, bae, but you know what I'm saying? I'm still way too sad for him. You know what I mean? But no, it just didn't give me what I, like, that smiley joint. I was expecting to have that type of reaction to at least five of these songs.
Right. And the biggest takeaway for me for the Certified Lover Boy is the fact that I'm not running back to any of these records, right? So like of course is good. There's some good music on here. Drake doesn't just make all bad music. And the more
he's not going to. Like, that would be, that's, yeah, an overkill to say.
Yeah. The more I'm listening to it, the better it's getting. And we only give certain artists that kind of chance. Like Drake, Ye, you know,
the
Kendrick.
Goats.
Yeah, the ghost we're going to listen to multiple times, even if we don't like it at first, mm-hmm, right? Because normally, imagine this was a new artist, and I'm thinking like, yo, how many fucking albums are we passing?
I wouldn't go back.
Exactly.
But
like,
because
how many
it's Drake.
It's because it's Drake. It's because it's Ye. We'll go back and listen to it and let the music grow with us. But like, I'm curious now. Like, some of these other albums that we listen to and stuff like that, like, damn, wonder how much other music I'm missing out on.
Good thing he dropped when he did drop, so he's not competing with some of those previous albums.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Because it was some good music that dropped.
Yeah. Of course, you know, the whole headlines were going crazy, you know, throughout this whole week, with them dropping so close together. We all expected that, of course, Drake is going to be projected to sell more. He just has a bigger audience, a bigger fan base at this point.
Kanye would have did just as well if he dropped when the fuck he said he was going to drop.
I agree.
Only did what he did because he was waiting on it.
Yeah, I agree. If Kanye probably would have dropped either the first time or at least by the second time, I would have expected him to probably get like 100K more streams. I would.
He had
that.
Us waiting. Some of us missed it.
Yeah.
But we got tired of waiting. Yeah. Like, first of all, you really was reaching by thinking that you was that nigga that we was really about to just sit around and wait for you forever. Yeah. You're not fucking us.
I was still impressed by his numbers in his debut. You know, Drake's numbers actually, to me, were interesting. Because, you know, he's projected to sell between 575 to 625. Kanye is at, like, 320 to 350 right now.
Mm-hmm.
So,
for a gospel album.
Yeah, for a gospel album. I mean, Kanye, of course, broke all kind of records. He's tied with Eminem with the most consecutive number one albums, which is an amazing, congratulations to him. Drake has the most streamed albums in one day, record and stuff like that, so congrats to him.
But he definitely did it the right way.
Yeah, he did. I mean, it was good marketing, but then I think about it too. Kanye dropped on a Sunday at 8 a.m. compared to, you know, where most people will drop Friday at midnight.
Right.
You know what I mean? So he had even less time to work with on the first day. So who knows what the number really would have been. And then the second day numbers are really interesting, mm-hmm. because Kanye streamed more his second day than Drake streamed his second day, which to me, that's very interesting as well, too.
Because we had to go back and listen to that Kanye joint. At this point, I felt like we could tell right off bat that Drake joint was not hit.
Yeah, because, and I think the major part about Drake's album is that this is no progression. There's no progression. It's a very, very safe album. This is not anything unexpected.
What the hell you been doing during COVID, Drake?
And apparently he must be busy doing something else other than music, because... And that's another thing, too.
Certified lover boy.
A lot of these records are old. And this is new for Drake. Like, there's at least 3 to 4 records on here that was on his leak. Like, his album leaked, like, a year ago.
Okay.
And, like, the record with Jay-Z on here, Love All, that used to be, like, Love 42 on the leak.
Okay.
And it didn't have Jay-Z on it. It was just Drake's verse. And literally, it came out, nothing changed except for just adding Jay-Z's verse. So, normally, when stuff like that happens, when a leak comes out for Drake, he takes that song off completely and... like, puts a brand new song. Like, this is very... It's weird to me.
So what is he doing? What do you think he's doing?
I think this album is like, okay, we're in a pandemic. I'm not going to be able to tour like we normally tour. I'm not going to be able to do this. This is like a throwaway to me. I think this is just like... It's just my time to drop music. I'm going to drop it right now, but it's not going to be my best. It's just like, this is what it is. Like, this is Drake, like, doing a layup with his left hand and he's right-handed.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like,
okay.
That's what I felt about this album. And of course, I think Kanye, one of the pieces of this, and this is another thing too that I found very interesting. Both albums have about the same features on there. And this is what made me think that they're actually cool, and that I think that they're all a part of this scheme.
Mm-hmm.
Including Drake. I mean, you have Lil Baby, Lil Durk, Travis Scott, Young Thug, let's see, who else is on there? Ty Dolla $ign on the same album. And then the two features that really surprised the fuck out of me, Jay-Z being on both albums,
mm-hmm.
and Kid Cudi being on both albums. Kid Cudi and Drake had beef. Beef. Like, mm-hmm. they were not cool with each other. They were not fucking with each other. Now, all of a sudden, they got a record together. Love that record. A lot of people who are fans of Kid Cudi... And Drake always wanted to hear a Kid Cudi Drake record, and, you know, finally we got that.
They got it.
But for Kid Cudi to be Kanye's guy and to be on Drake's album is really unique to me. You know what I mean? You know, The Weeknd being on Kanye's album, you know, that's weird to me, too. But so a lot of these features are the same. And I really...
That was like marketing to me when I seen it. I was like, What a good business.
Right. And of course, like, these are the hot guys that are out right now. Mm-hmm. These are the people that people are checking for and stuff like that.
Like, how do you not have them on there?
Yeah. But I really, truly believe that Kanye and Drake got cool, and then they didn't get cool. Like, something happened again. Like, they got cool, and then something else happened. Because I believe that they were on each other's album. I believe that Kanye had a Drake feature, and Drake had a Kanye feature on both their albums. I do believe that. But I think something else happened, like, during this rollout situation, mm-hmm. which made them not cool. And Drake kind of speaks on that a little bit on one of the records.
Mm-hmm.
Like, why am I going to keep, you know, piecing it up with you if we're just going to keep getting back to the same state?
Right.
You know what I mean?
What is there to beef about? Like, what the hell do y'all have to beef about?
Ego. These are two guys. Like, Drake really feels like he's the greatest out here. Like, he really, right now I think he is.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, at one point he was stepping on Jay-Z's toes. And people just like, you know, you still got to respect Jay-Z for being Jay-Z. So now Drake is kind of like, okay, it's me and Jay, and Kanye, you just sliding in third type shit. You know what I mean? He really feels like the throne is him and Jay and not Kanye. And he feels like Kanye needs to step aside, and Kanye's just like, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. I'm still him.
Yeah, you're tripping.
Yeah. But the thing is, I think the two legends could coexist. You know what I mean? I think, and it's also timing, too. Like, I see them as different classes, you know what I mean? Like, you can't compare a Jay-Z to a Drake. It's like comparing Michael Jordan to LeBron James. It's just different. they're both great in their time. Jay-Z is, he held his class. Mm-hmm. Kanye held his class. And I think right now is Drake's class, until Kendrick drops. It's Drake's class. Okay? Now, before we get into some of this music, because I do want to play some records on here and react to them a little bit. One thing I found very interesting. The boogeyman is coming.
The boogeyman.
To say his name, Candyman. So, Kendrick. Kendrick, I believe, sat at home, man. This is just my analogy, what I'm thinking Kendrick is doing, right? Like, this is the nerve of me.
Okay.
But this album drops. It's mid. People know it's mid for Drake standards, right? Kendrick Lamar
is laughing
his ass off. You know what he did? The next day, Kendrick don't do shit. But you know what he did?
What'd he do?
The next day, he registered 30 songs. He uploaded. They're not out yet.
Right.
They're not out yet. But he uploaded about 30 records, which is pushing for. People are speculating that his album is coming very, very soon. I do believe Kendrick Lamar is coming very soon. Like, it's not like, I really wish he would drop this week coming up, because this would shut this whole shit down.
We won't even be talking about them no more.
Right. It'll be both of them get out the way.
Especially now that he knows what to do. He probably already got 100 songs in the chamber. Like, okay, heard this nigga.
Right.
Give me the best 24 songs.
Right. It's just like, Kendrick, like, has the big joker in his hand. Like, that's how I feel right now. And this is the perfect time to drop. If he don't drop next week, I think he's going to drop either by the end of the month or next month. I think it's coming that soon. And I can't wait, man. I'm excited for it.
Yeah, because, you one of the greats. Yeah. Cole already dropped.
Yeah.
All the greats have dropped.
Yeah.
So now it's only right that you get in the conversation.
Yeah, it's definitely Kendrick's turn. And I believe he's coming because we got that verse from him and Baby King with Family Ties.
He's working.
He's brewing up some stuff. And, like, the fact he got 30 records, like, coming. Like, Kendrick's never dropped an album with that many records. And if we get a 30, I'm not gonna lie, if we get a 30 track.
That's a little intense.
It is intense.
Because Kendrick is intense.
He is. But
I don't know how I feel about that. Like, I like Kendrick.
Yeah.
But I don't love Kendrick.
Right.
I respect Kendrick and his artistry and his different styles. I love his visuals. I'm just gonna throw that out there. I don't think I've seen a video that I don't like.
Right. Yeah.
But 30 songs?
I'm here for all 30.
I know you are. I know you are. I'm going to be in here like, couldn't get past out. Couldn't get past 20.
Hey, that's still good.
That is still good, but I still would have to listen.
Yeah. Man. All right. So, Certified Lover Boy. If I'm going to rate it.
Me.
Low, medium, or high.
Low, mid.
It's giving medium vibes for sure, man. I'm going to give Certified Lover Boy a 7. I'm going to give it a 7 right now out of 10. Just because it has been growing on me. And there's some records I will go back to. But I don't have a favorite. I don't have a standout favorite that I'm going to go back and listen to this. It's just like...
it's a got to, like, no.
Yeah.
No. It's blowing my mind that I fuck with Cole's album so hard. I'm not a Cole fan.
Right.
I'm not a Cole fan. So when another artist even has me feeling that way over my favorite artist, and I want to be biased.
Right, of course. I know. I was ready for you to come in here and be biased. I'm just like, okay, I'm going to have to go against Jamila and the Drake. Austin's not here right now, thank God, because I already know he would have been going off about this Drake album. He already talked to me about it, how he felt about it.
I seen him in the group chat. Yeah. It was like only person that was standing up for Donda was Chad, right?
Yeah, it was Chad.
I think I love some of the stuff Chad was saying. Yeah. I ain't really come out there and say too much, but I can't be biased. I gotta keep it a band. Like, there's not a song that really sparks my soul, like, at all.
I spoke to Chad on the phone, and you know, like, Austin made a good point. I'm gonna say one thing Austin didn't mention. He said that Drake is kind of like Chick-fil-A.
He's consistent. I said that before. Simply. Yes.
Yeah. That's just like, that's a very, very good analogy. But if Drake is Chick-fil-A,
but Chick-fil-A is not all of that. Let's be very clear. Like, and I don't care what anybody got to say. If you Chick-fil-A lovers got anything to say,
but I mean, if you want a chicken sandwich, do you want Chick-fil-A? Do you want McDonald's? You know what I mean? Like,
right?
It's that. You
but
know
I'm
what
gonna
mean?
Keep it a. I'm gonna keep it 100 with you though. Mm-hmm. McDonald's chicken sandwich back in the day used to be better than Chick-fil-A joint.
I don't know.
They just switched the joint. When they had the joint on the honey wheat bread, like a while, like this was years ago from McDonald's. I stab it was better than Chick-fil-A joint.
I don't know, man. I'm telling you.
Y'all don't remember, but I remember.
I remember. I know right now Chick-fil-A is becoming like the number one fast food chain in America. And
it's not because of their product.
It's their
customer service and their consistency.
It's their consistency. And they don't even have to be open. What blows me is that they're open 6 days out of the week instead of 7 days out of the week like these other
and
places.
And they stand on that shit.
And they stand on that shit and they're making more profit than the other. That says a lot. So I'll give that to Drake. You know, I was like, yeah.
They
Drake
care about
like,
our time. Like, they're the ones who came up with the double line before anybody else was even thinking about it. For years, we was thinking that out of McDonald's. We know they had the money.
Right.
We know they had the money, but they didn't care about us enough. Yeah. Chick-fil-A is not only have the second line, they making sure that their employees are good. They make sure that their customers are good. They make sure the food is edible.
And you can tell that they're trying, right? You can tell by the way how they do business and stuff like that. They do care about the customers and they want to deliver. Now, like I said, if Drake is Chick-fil-A, Kanye is Apple. And I say this because Kanye is innovative, mm-hmm. he's creative, mm-hmm. and even when he failed, like when Apple took a dip and the iPhones was going under,
iPhones are not all of that.
But this is what they did. When they started going down in sales, Tim Cook was like, I got you. Wearables, AirPods, appliances. When he started flipping shit like that, mm-hmm. their stock and their price went through the roof. 65% of their revenue went to wearables, AirPods, watches, yep. and stuff like that. It's not the phone. So mm-hmm. I feel like that with Kanye. I feel like Kanye, like even though like the last couple of albums, y'all probably say it's mid, he's still going to come back and do some different shit, some creative shit.
I got all the Apple products, and I know that they're not the best.
Right.
But they are the Chick-fil-A of mm-hmm. our technology. You know what I mean? It's consistent. It's going to work. Like, if it's not, I can take it back. Like,
continuity.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
it's like, I love how everything just flows seamlessly with all the products that they offer. Like, mm-hmm. but I know that iPhone is not the best. Mm-hmm. All the updates and shit that my Android could do back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
Like, seriously, like, it's really sad. Like, they real live upgrade the phone and give us something that the Androids already use.
Yeah, I know. iPhone came out with this new feature. I'm so glad they did, too. I love traveling, guys. So I like going out the country, different places, stuff like that. And Android had this feature where you could actually, like, use your photos
mm-hmm.
and, like, take a picture or scan, like, a sign or mm-hmm. something like that in a different language, and it will translate it for you
mm-hmm.
just by looking at it. I'm just like, that is super dope. Almost made me want to get an Android. But, like, I still don't want my messages green. So, like, I'm still stuck with Apple. And now Apple just finally came out with that shit now, too. Just like, yes, thank you.
And there's so many things that they got in the chamber that they keep acting like they're doing us a favor with.
Yeah.
They're not doing us a favor. We can just simply get an Android.
But see, what Apple prides itself is, and this is, we're not going to be stuck on this, guys. We're going to move on. But Apple is not pressed about being first with their stuff. They're pressed about being the best.
Simple and simplicity.
Yeah.
They're not trying to be first at anything. They're literally last. Like, literally, I had an Android before.
Mm-hmm.
There were things that I could do with my Android that I know that you could still do with your Android that I know that I cannot do with my iPhone.
Mm-hmm.
Like little things that we should be able to do. We know damn well that cheating is at an all-time high,
oh, yeah.
right? I remember back in the day on the Android, I used to be able to have my messages in different folders. I could download apps that would lock certain messages that I could little shit.
Mm-hmm.
Why we can't do that?
What are we doing, Jamila?
No, this is when I was a kid, and I didn't want my parents like going through my phone and shit like that. So I used to put my messages, like certain messages, in a vault, just in case I ever got audited.
Right. Hey, you know what I'm saying? That's hilarious.
Why we can't do that?
I mean, you can. You can jailbreak the phone. You can jailbreak the phone. I think there is an app that you guys should do that.
But I thought they stopped jailbreaking on the iPhone. I thought you can't. I think you can't do it anymore. Not like how we used to. And that's a whole nother thing. I used to jailbreak my phone.
Right.
It was an Android, bruh. It was like real live, like an Android on the iPhone.
You still had the blue messages.
Still had the blue messages. You know what I'm saying? But I was able to download Android apps and stuff like that allowed me to do certain things on my phone. The customization of the phone. Like, we're just now able to design our home screen, bro. Why were we so geeked about that? When you Ben could do that. Since the beginning of time on Android.
It's Apple, man.
I'm just saying. Not the best, but consistent. And, I mean, I still got it. I'm still going to buy the 13.
I'm probably going to wait. I normally do mine in 2 years spans. Like, I don't do it every year. I do it in 2 years spans. But I'm definitely going to buy the Apple stock right now. You know what I mean? Keep buying that shit.
I got a few shares or whatever.
Okay. All right. So, Certified Lover Boy. We say it's mid. It seems like a lot of people agree with it too. Like, I really try not to get like that many people's reactions, like before listening to it. Mm-hmm. But after I listened to it a couple of times and then looked at the people's reactions, it's just like, oh wow, I'm not alone. Like, a lot of people are saying this. Time,